from the left side of the track, you proceed already flat out. So stop braking at the exclamation mark until the 5 kilometer sign, and then you can have a nice smooth turn in. Good morning, comrades. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the Nürburgring Nordschleife, quite literally where I'm standing right now. Welcome to the second part of our first lap of the year series, where I will be showing you the Nordschleife from on foot perspective, where I will tell you a bit about the corner names, about how, like, some interesting details that you will otherwise also miss when you're driving the car. So yesterday we made it from Sabine Schmitz towards here to Hoheichen section, where we will proceed to Quiddebacher Höhe. And the first detail you can actually see, I hope you can actually see it on camera, is the big elevation and camber changes that actually make this section quite challenging for lots of drivers. So you have here a big camber change, and also because there you can see some, I think those are needles from the pine trees over there that are dropped. So you can actually see that it goes to a dip, and actually it goes up again before it goes down again, and then you have a straight. So these things is something that you do not notice, but you need to be aware of every single bump, of every sink, of every bit of camber, of every different tarmac transition section if you're driving fast, because those small changes when you're driving the car on the limit, they make big impact on the change of the characteristics of the car, on the driving dynamics. So very important. All right, let's proceed to the interesting, what do we have here? I want to say let's proceed to the straight, but there's just like a random curbstone, just goes there and kind of ends again. Things that you would otherwise not see when you're driving the car and going towards 250 kilometers per hour depending on the car on this straight section. Going downhill flat out towards Quiddebacher Bridge, and you can see that from here it looks kind of blind. That's why a lot of people who do not know the track, actually that everyone should be doing, brake for it. But it's a flat out section, just aim for the right side of the bridge towards Quiddebacher before entering Flugplatz. And these are indeed needles. Yeah, needles from the pine trees. So hopefully they'll be gone before the track opens in 2.5-ish months. Well, otherwise I'm sure Nürburgring will clean them up. Some people may not even know that this is actually a bridge that goes over a public road, because yeah, Nordschleife is quite big, 20.832 kilometers, and inside it, I believe you have 5 to 7 different villages, depending which district you would count as a village. You can actually see the castle from here, and over here is an old hotel that hasn't been used in forever because it has no water connection. There are so many myths around it that someone poisoned the groundwater, or because they just cannot make a connection to it. But actually, since recent days, someone has been either living there or just staying there, and whoever knows this person, sometimes you can actually go on top of it and take some pictures. It's very interesting. But in the past, like in the 70s and the 80s, you would still see this hotel being crowded, populated, and people sitting there sipping margaritas or Eiffelgeist and watching the cars go by. Very nice experience. One of the things that I haven't mentioned this year yet is whenever you have an incident or accident, or you just need to get off the track safely because you see you have all the barriers next to it and it's kind of unsafe to park just somewhere on the track, if you have a technical issue with the car because there are lots of cars coming behind you, look for orange barriers. Orange barriers means that there's a safety pocket where you can safely park the car behind, or sometimes even exit completely the track to avoid, yeah, to avoid blocking other cars and causing accidents. So we are approaching Quiddebacher. A lot of people make the mistake of calling it Flugplatz because Flugplatz translates as an airfield. And in the past, there was a bump here before 2016 where cars would literally take off, which you still do in a Assetto Corsa, for example, and also iRacing. So you really need to slow down for that. I think iRacing, not sure. The bump is gone in R-Factor 2 because they do have a like more later version of the laser scan track. But yeah, it is still Quiddebacher, and with the bump gone, actually it's a very it's a lot faster section of the track now, because you don't have to worry about your car going off mid-air. You can actually go coasting there, brake a bit before having a very high speed entry of, yeah, depending on the setup of your car, 160 kilometers per hour, I would say, for a road car, towards 180. A race car, depending on the aero levels, 180 to 210 kilometers per hour. Yeah, quite fast, quite a fast section, but you really need to know the layout of the track to be able to commit. But it's also one of my favorite sections of the track, and also a very important one for lap times, because after that you have a fast straight towards Schwedenkreuz and Arnberg. Hello, frohes neues, happy new year. Just like I mentioned yesterday's video, like, people do it, but officially it's not allowed. I just have to say it. In case also you have a technical issue, luckily there is some sort of gravel that could slow you down for like 10 centimeters before you would hit the barrier, but it's a straight, so it's not really there. But what I wanted to show you is I'm holding the camera straight right now, and you can see the angle, the elevation change through this section. Well, luckily, unless you're driving the Benz patent wagon, which Jimmy Broadbent did a few weeks ago, I believe, in a Assetto Corsa, you don't have to worry about having enough speed, worry about carrying enough speed to make it up the hill. When they did the resurfacing works at the end of 2015, towards the 2016 season, you can see that the surface transition is really smooth. So, as mentioned, you can carry a lot of speed and go on the brakes. And as mentioned in yesterday's video, am I already out of breath? Yeah, well, it was quite a high hill, and especially when you talk as much as I do, then you may forget to actually to work on your breathing exercises. As mentioned in yesterday's videos, some reference points, a lot of reference points that you can use are actually those dot markings that are used by driving schools such as BMW Driving Academy, Scuderia Hanseat, etc. Dots, they show either braking points or reference points, so you kind of need to know which one is which, but most of the times they're actually turning points. So from here you can also see how the line is going. You can have smooth turning towards the right curbstone, unless of course it's wet, then you should stay a bit to the outside and have wet line. And this is also something that we will see later on. Again, another safety pocket with the orange barrier to show you that you can get there. If it's a wet line, what I said, something we will see later on. Over there, there's another marking. So I would say almost that it is a marking for a wet turn-in. But it doesn't look like, it looks like something else. Like more of a official marking to indicate maybe like water connection or something, maybe like that. Hello? Oh, some plant. I was expecting to find some car parts. There's a bolt there. Yeah. Luckily, not that many accidents happen here most of the time. So it's a relatively safe section, but if something goes wrong, it's a very high speed section. So all in all, just like the rest of the track, watch out. And if you're going too much to the outside, don't worry, because you have, again, 10 centimeters of gravel that will probably slow you down half a kilometer per hour or 0.2 miles per hour, and the conversion is probably wrong. So let's proceed with talking more about the track, things that I do know more about than actually metric to imperial conversions. So we have here another small runoff area that you could use. Here, this rumble strip, but you have to be going really, really fast. And then from the left side, I know this is right, but we're facing the opposite direction. From the left side of the track, you proceed already flat out. To the right curbstone and to the outside, and you keep it flat towards Schwedenkreuz, unless of course you would like to stop for a picnic at one of the spectator areas, which is unfortunately today not functional anymore officially. As I am on my way towards Schwedenkreuz and the picnic area to take a little break, I'd like to use this opportunity to talk to you a bit off topic. How are you guys doing today? By the time this video gets published, for me it's the 1st of January, for you it should be the 2nd of January. How are you doing? How are you feeling? Like, have you started? Have you changed your life? Have you have like I don't know, you started going to the gym maybe? Have you done something else, maybe first preparations to start a business? Or like, are you keeping up your New Year's resolution? Because sometimes second day is actually already quite tough one, because the first day you're full of motivation, then you're thinking like, what's the point? Or there are lots of things that can hold you back. So I would like to know how you guys are doing. And also, how was your actually New Year's Eve? Haven't asked you yesterday. I'm quite curious how it was. Like, for me, it was quite funny. I might as well share it with you. Like, I was with George and Diana and Karen, George's girlfriend. And I was sitting on George's simulator. And then as I was changing the racetrack, I saw in the corner of the screen of Windows, I'm like, oh, guys, it's like 20 minutes to midnight. Like, oh, if you wouldn't have said anything, we probably would have missed the New Year's. And then we kind of kept track of the time. And by the time it was almost midnight, we're like, what should we do? Should we go outside? Should we go to the city? Should we do something? Like, nah, let's just go to the balcony. And like 15 seconds to midnight, I was still pouring myself a glass of whiskey. Like, and then I went to the balcony, like, well, happy New Year. Yeah, okay, thanks. And now what? It was one of the most underwhelming and weird New Year's Eves. Underwhelming and weird, but still not a bad one, because I spent it with the people I like a lot and enjoy spending time with. So overall, it was nice. It was definitely not bad, but definitely not something that we were used to of doing years ago. Hopefully this year it will change. In any case, we have now almost arrived at our spectator area, and also one thing that we can see that we usually cannot see when we drive fast with our cars is the amazing view over there. Like all the beautiful hills covered in fog currently. It's very nice. You know, it's actually very warm. Oh, check out my Gopnik stuff t-shirt, because why not? It's warm. Because it's warm, and which is weird because last year we had snow, global warming, which is going to be probably freezing next week anyway. Yeah, but also because of the elevation changes that I have to walk through. Right, we have arrived at the highest point of Schwedenkreuz, where actually this corner section name is Cottenborn, named after the village of Cottenborn on the left side over there. And yeah, another orange berry. Let me, by the way, switch the microphone to be rear biased. So now you should be able to hear me or understand a bit better. Orange barrier, we have here a safety pocket, but actually it's like a complete parking lot, and this is the picnic area that I was talking about, where in the past you could just go here, park up here, enjoy the view, watch the cars go by. But nowadays, unfortunately, it's just a safety area. You should not stop anywhere unless it is an actual emergency. And now it's just being used as a marshal post. You have a nice bathroom over here, you have a nice booth over here, and you have the old school telephone connection that you can use to call in the marshals in case of an emergency. Marshal post 82, and then I don't have the key, but inside there is a telephone, because phone connection, as in like nowadays, like the modern wireless connections, you don't have coverage everywhere, but these are just lines like connected from the very early old days, from the 20s and 30s, and they always function, never change the broken system, or like working system, sorry. Speaking of which, another thing that I haven't mentioned yet this year is you see those numbers. Those are marshal posts that indicate where you are on the track. So in case you have an incident or accident or something, or you need to warn the safety, for some reason you have the SOS number, you should really save it in your phone that you can call up, and it's going to connect you directly to the marshal office. Someone last year made a comment saying like, well, the 111 is just enough to dial. No, this will take you to the country code, and they'll be like, who you want to, what's your emergency? You want to speak to the police department, fire department, or ambulance? No, this 112 number, the complete with 0-8000 or plus 49-8000, will take you to the marshal office of the Nürburgring. Then you can tell them like, yo, I'm at the marshal post 92, and either I have a breakdown or there's another car that needs assistance. Please send someone, please start waving yellow flags, etc., etc. Very, very, very important, so make sure to do it. Another just like a small interesting point, here it's white, here it's black. just to indicate if you had an incident, you spun out and you don't know which direction you're facing. White is the right direction, the proper direction, and black, this means you're facing opposite direction. So make sure to turn around as soon as possible without driving off. I'm going to be this curious, annoying kid and see what's here, because it looks not just like a bench, but well, marshal equipment still. Good. Cool. That's good. On the other hand, you know, someone might say, like, Misha, you should not show this because some idiot is going to come here and steal a fire extinguisher. On the other hand, I'm like, if we're living in such a sad society, I don't even know. But let's proceed to the rest of the track. Unfortunately, you cannot exit the parking lot through here anymore, back on the track like you could in the old days. Yeah, so you just need to stay on the track and proceed going flat out over this beautiful, amazing piece of tarmac that has been laid in the winter of 2018 to 2019. So this whole section has been repaved and it's very smooth and fast to drive on. The sun is setting down. I'm not even sure if I'll be able to finish today's first half of the lap. But in any case, you're traveling high speed in a straight line as possible from the curbstone, from the parking lot that we saw over there. And then in the past, before 2019, you would have here a jump, which you still have in some racing, sim racing games, which would make the braking zone over here quite more challenging. But now, as you can see, it's a flat and smooth surface, so you can carry quite a lot of speed through here. And then I always say that you can use the exclamation mark and the 5 kilometer sign as a pretty safe reference point for braking. So start braking at the exclamation mark until the 5 kilometer sign, and then you can have a nice smooth turn in towards Arenberg. The very challenging aspect of Schwedenkreuz after the braking zone is that you can see you have a crest. We're, by the way, facing the opposite direction here, so you can already know, well, that's actually a good indication. You can see the bikers coming over the crest, and then you would go towards the left curbstone, but quite often you do not expect the car. Hey, Happy New Year!
Happy New Year.
I think it was Tilo. Right, this is actually a nice indication. So there you have the crest again facing in the opposite direction, and then you don't expect the corner to be actually this tight. And what happens then is actually you go full on the brakes and end up in the barrier. Yep. So knowing the track dimensions is key, and also knowing the capabilities of your car, your suspension settings, your suspension limitations, your aerodynamic limitations as well, is very important through this high speed section. And then you have here this cute little curbstone on the left side, and I usually say that the end of the curb is a nice reference point for the hard braking towards Arenberg. And then all the way from there, the end of the curbstone, what we're just at right now, it's a long braking zone towards either this dot or the orange barrier that is actually quite easy to spot, or easier to spot, which you can use as a turning point into Arenberg. Otherwise you would end up in the gravel, which you shouldn't be doing. And for now, for today, I'm actually gonna stop this video here and walk back to Pancake, and tomorrow we'll proceed with the other sections of the track on our first lap of the year series, I would say, where we do what we used to do for the last 2 days. And I hope you guys sincerely enjoyed this series, and looking forward to seeing you tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. I just hope that the weather is going to be as good as it is today.